Hello, I'm Tristan from Smart Home Point. So, back in 2019, the smart home community was a buzz. Is that a word? A buzz with talk about connected home over IP, or CHOIP. This was apparently the saving grace that would finally allow us to take our 500 different smart home devices produced by 300 different companies and allow them to seamlessly talk to each other. Okay, the reality of this will almost certainly be different. But regardless, it's still a positive development. However, CHOIP has now been renamed to Matter, possibly because they realised that CHOIP was a really stupid name. Who knows? Now, Matter could be a big deal. Some might even say that it matters. That won't be the last cheesy pun in this video. Anywho, Philips Hue have recently announced that they will support Matter. This seems like a pretty big deal, because if someone in the future comes out with an awesome new RGB remote, which is better than this, that is Matter compatible, it can then be used to control your Hue lights, no matter who produces that new RGB remote. Another example, imagine that Elon Musk develops a fancy new smart voice assistant that takes over the world. The Musk smart speaker is awesome in every way. Control your Tesla, smart home and love life using your brainwaves, or maybe just your voice. Supports Thread, Matter and the Martian atmosphere. Brainwave control requires Neuralink Pro subscription. Martian support requires SpaceX Premium, both available separately. The Musk smart speaker, here to take over the world. I'd totally buy that. If the Musk speaker is Matter compatible as well, this could also control your Philips Hue ecosystem, even if the Philips Hue company no longer exists, for that matter. That's because Matter is a connectivity standard, which is a fancy way of saying that loads of smart home companies have come together and they are agreeing a way for their devices to speak to each other, in a common way. And this can be work locally without the internet being required. It doesn't matter whether a smart device uses Wi-Fi, Bluetooth or Thread. As long as the device itself is Matter compatible, it can speak to other Matter compatible devices. And that is no laughing matter. After all, right now, most smart devices seem to support Amazon and often Google Home, but HomeKit support is quite hit and miss. And support for lesser known smart hubs and voice assistants is rare. But the Matter project can change all this by finally agreeing and enforcing a common way that all our smart devices can speak to each other. Back to the matter at hand. How does all this help Philips Hue? In fact, does it help Philips Hue? Well, yes and no. I already mentioned that if there's a fancy new RGB remote or smart speaker in the future, as long as it's Matter compatible, it can control your Philips Hue system. And that's naturally good, but guess what? You can do that already, as a matter of fact. Zigbee-enabled devices can already control your Hue lights, as we've seen with Amazon's recent Echo devices that contain a little Zigbee chip that then supports Philips Hue's lights without requiring a Hue Bridge. Plus, right now, all that being Matter compatible really means is that it will support Amazon Echo, Google Home, and HomeKit-based devices. But Philips Hue supports all three of these anyway. When Elon Musk launches his new smart speaker that takes over the world, Philips Hue will just probably do a software update to the Hue Bridge to support the Musk speaker as well. And whilst it's good that a lot more companies have signed up to the Matter project than the Zigbee Alliance, I must shed some light on this matter and point out that Philips Hue supporting Matter could actually be a bad thing. Wait, what? Well, Hue has confirmed that the Hue Bridge will be upgraded to support Matter. That means that the individual Hue lights and switches will not be Matter compatible. They will still run over Zigbee and require the Hue Bridge. And this gets us to the root of the matter. Your individual Hue lights, motion sensors, and their accessories will be unable to talk to other Thread-compatible devices. So, the biggest benefit of our future smart homes, access to the robust Thread-based mesh network, will be unavailable to the individual Philips Hue components. You still need the clunky Hue Bridge for that. And even then, the Hue Bridge won't be speaking Thread, it'll be Ethernet. I realise that I haven't actually discussed Thread yet, and I don't want to confuse things and make matters worse. So, Thread is a low-power IPv6-based protocol that forms a mesh network. That means that it's a rival to Zigbee and Z-Wave because they also form mesh networks, whereby each device can link to each other, creating a fault-tolerant and flexible network. If one device in the network goes offline, it's fine because your smart home commands can just be routed via other devices in the actual Thread network. Thread is internet protocol based, meaning that it fits much more easily into the internet-based world that we live in. After all, it's likely that some internet routers in the future will support Thread, but none really support Zigbee or Z-Wave. So whilst it's not exactly a matter of life and death that Hue lights won't support Thread, it's still unfortunate because Thread is the main communication protocol within the Matter connectivity standard, alongside Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. Zigbee isn't even an option within the standard. Now, you would have thought that it's just a matter of time before Philips Hue brings out a Hue Bridge version 3 that does support Thread. But right now, that doesn't seem to be planned. The Hue Bridge version 2 seems here to stay. What this means in practice is that, as I mentioned earlier, your Philips Hue lights and accessories will not be Matter or Thread compliant. They will continue to be Zigbee based. And then just the Hue Bridge version 2 will be Matter compatible, but not Thread compatible. And so the actual benefits of this are going to be fairly minimal, in my opinion. Remember that Hue could just introduce a software update for the Musk smart speaker when it takes over the world, whether or not Matter exists, too. So that wraps up my thoughts on this matter. The fact of the matter is, what's the matter? Sorry, I don't know what the matter is with me today. Summing up, it's good that Philips Hue will support Matter, but the real world difference will probably be minimal. What matters more to me is whether Philips Hue's lights will start to introduce Thread support in the future generations. Doing this will then allow Philips Hue to get rid of the Hue Bridge altogether. We'll see. For now, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button, which will tell YouTube that more people should see this video. Please also consider subscribing to my channel and clicking the little bell icon, which will notify you when I release new videos. Thank you.